कार्यम अर्थ्यम यशस्यम च सोपदेशं ससंग्रहम् शास्त्रार्थ संपन्नम्
शिल्प प्रवर्तकम्
नाट्याद्यं पञ्चमं वेदं
Kushali, come on, try this one.
Mother, babe, we were just trying some postures from the beautiful Karanas in your thesis.
Didi, please teach us Karanas.
Certainly, but you have to follow the methodology given by Bharata for training the body to do full justice to the Karanas. You have to go step by step and first master the elements of Angika Abhinaya.
Is Abhinaya not a facial expression?
Abhinaya is a nomenclature for the art of communication. It is classified as four: Angika physical, Vachika verbal, Aharya ornamental, and Satvika emotional. This classification is of universal and timeless value. The four mediums of expressions are to be mastered by the actors called Natas. According to Natya Shastra, we have seen that the term Natya means drama. The common root for these terms is Nat, meaning to act, thus carrying forward the stories along with the emotions, evoking the consequent aesthetic experience.
In Angika Abhinaya, which is a major topic, the trained movement of the body is classified as Sharira. The untrained natural action of the body, which may also be used in drama, is Cheshtakrita. The facial expressions come under Mukhaja. Sharira is further classified as Shakha, that is hand gestures and arm movements, Ankura, imaginative usage of the gestures, and Nritta, which is actual dance using the whole body. For example, this is Lakshmi. In Ankura, I could show her as the one who resides in Vishnu's chest. When it is Nritta, it would be the milk ocean, and when this ocean is churned, there came a beautiful damsel, and that's Lakshmi. Under Shakha, we have the Abhinayahastas, Hastakaranas, Bahukarmas, and Nrittahastas. And again, under Nritta, we have the classification of the limbs of the body as Angas, major limbs, and Upangas, minor limbs.
The Angas include the head, the chest, the sides, the waist, the feet, and hands. And by hands, the entire range of Shakha is implied.
Upangas are further classified as the minor limbs of the body and the minor limbs of the face.
How scientific and logical.
The Natya Shastra insists on training of all the Angas and Upangas. The names of the respective movements are enlisted in the form of verses. My disciples will demonstrate the basic elements from the Natyashastra, and perhaps it would be interesting to compare the traditional regional adherence to the same. The Shirobedha, or the head variations, are 13 in number.
Akampitam kampitam cha dhutam vidhutam eva cha parivahita udvahitakam avadhutam tatha anchitam nihanchitam paravrittam ukshiptam chapyadhogatam lolitam chaiva vinyeyam trayodasha vidham shirah.
We in Kerala use all these in our Ottandulla.
Muralidhar, these are all based on human behavior with an artistic coating. Nobody would use dhutam to say you are most welcome. Now you will have the chest variations, Urobheda.
Abhugnamatha nirbhugnam tatha chaiva prakampitam udvahitam samam chaiva uraha panchavidham smritam.
Now you will have the Parshva Bheda, or movements of the sides.
Natam samunnatam chiva prasarita vivartite tatha apashrutameva tu parshvayoho karma panchadha.
Guruji, will you please demonstrate how all these Parshva Bhedas are commonly used in Manipuri technique? We have Kati Bheda for training the waist.
Chinna chaiva nivritta cha rejita kampita tatha udvahita cheti kati natye nritte cha panchadha.
We use kati in Ottandullal to show the strength of Hanuman's tail. Muriyum nendado ninde gadayo nammude valo.
Didi, for the Tribhanga, the training of both the waist and sides are most relevant, isn't it?
The Natyashastra gives you the terms for what you practice in Orissi. For Tribhanga, you could either have an Udvahita Kati or an Unnata Parshva, or it could be even both. Bharatanatyam uses the Natha variety of Parshva, thus leading to Dvibhanga.
Bhangi in Malayalam means beautiful. What do you mean by Bhanga?
Aray, Bhanga in Hindi means beautiful.
Ha! Krishnanam Bakasham.
Bhanga literally means break. Here it means the deflections of the body line to create beauty. Now this is Sama. With a slight bend, it becomes Abhanga.
Didi, this is often seen in Kuchipudi. Apragarandane, Kadagali Sriveshatlu Mundi.
And in many other forms also. In Dvibhanga, you have a clear deflection.
As we do in Nataravu also. Tai, tai, titi, tai, tai.
Now with three deflections, it becomes Tribhanga.
As we often perform in Odissi,
Pada Bedha gives you the basic variations of the feet.
Udghattitah samaschaiva tata agrakala sancharah anchitah kunchitaschaiva padah panchavidhah smritah.
In Sama, the entire sole touches the ground. Let us see Samapada simultaneously performed in Bharatanatyam, Mohiniyattam, Orissi, Kathak and Ottanthullal styles. Anchita, the Natyadal of Bharatanatyam used in all styles. Sanchara is to plant the toes. This is Kuttadal in Tamil. Udghattita is method of Bharatanatyam. All Deshi styles retain it. Kunchita is to have an arched soul, as we often see in Western classical ballet. Lord Nataraja's raised foot is called Kunchita Pada because it is arched. Manipuri in Northeast and Kathakali in South use Kunchita sole, but they balance on the sides of the soles. Technically, it is called Parshni Pada in Sanskrit and Vadimbu Padam in Tamil. In Manipuri, we call this Pada Vedas Khongtha Makhal. For example,
Khongdol, Kuning, Khongpak, Khudon Nathaba, Khudon, Khongchep.
The Natya Shastra gives six sthanas or basic stances for the body, just as the Western classical ballet dancers have positions numbered for practicing their movements. These are based on the direction in which the toes are turned, the space between the feet, and also the reduction in the height of the body. These are all common to Indian sculpture and Indian dance. The sthanas are
Vaishnavam Samapadam Cha Vaishakham मंडलम तथा प्रत्यालीडम तथा लीडम स्थानान येतानि षण्ड्रणाम.
समा इज द मेन स्थाना ऑफ कथक.
इट हेल्प्स अस टू गेन स्पीड.
Mandalasthana is the aramandi of our Bharatanatyam. Both Vaishnava and Mandalasthanas.
Vaishnavasthana called Thongkho in Cholam Tandava. In Orissi, we call this is Chauka. We have Mandala and also Vaishnava.
Now you can see Pratyalidasthana and Vaishagasthana in Kathakali. Thank you.
We have Alida Sthana in Thangta, that is the sword and spear dances.
Kagadhan tat dhari! Kagadhari!
Apart from these, we have three special sthanas for enhancing feminine grace.
Strinam sthanani karyani gatishva bhashaneshu cha ayatam cha avahittam cha ashvakrantam athapi cha.
The concept of feminine grace has been common to our entire Bharat from very remote times. This icon is from Mohenjo-daro of the Indus Valley civilization. It is an ayatasthana. The same posture is described by poet Kalidasa for Malavika, his dancer heroine. That's from Madhya Pradesh region. You have the same flow of body lines in the beautiful South Indian bronzes of Devi figures. It is still a living tradition.
All these sthanas or firip in Manipuri are used in our lasya, for example. This last one is also called Sagol Kirep, which means horse posture.
Oh, it's same as Ashvakranta in name and form.
Nati Shastra transcends time and space and is very much a living tradition.
What a striking uniformity and continuity.
Amazing! The basic standards of Nati Shastra are common to all dances.
Ekam Satu Tata Vipra Bahuda Vadanti. Reality or truth is one. It is only recognized differently.
Next, let's take up the concept of Adavu.
Units of dance is Adavu. What about other Desi styles?
We also say Adavu in Mohiniyattam.
And even in the martial art of Kalaripayat in Kerala.
Thevarattam, which is another martial art of Tamil Nadu, also uses the term Adavu. Of course, it is used in Andhra and Karnataka. The term Adavu is used in Sinhalese dance of Sri Lanka, popularly called Kandyan. So, Adavu has been the common term for unit of dance in South India from around 12th century. Adiyarku Nallar, in his commentary on the great Tamil epic Shilapadikaram, has mentioned three categories of dances to be mastered by the gurus of his times. He mentions the Deshi, which is the regional dance of Tamil Nadu, the Vadugu, which is the dance of the Telugu-speaking area, and the Singalam, which is the dance of the Sinhalese of the present Sri Lanka. Adavu is actually still the contemporary unit of dance. Perhaps its root could be traced to Adal, meaning dance, Adi, meaning step, or Attam, meaning moving, all in Tamil, or Adugu, meaning also step in Telugu, or even Atana in Sanskrit, meaning moving around. For example, you have Shiva as Bhikshatana Murti, moving around for Bhiksha or alms.
Didi, how many Adavs do we have in Bharatanatyam?
Adavu is a Desi term. When I went through some works of the 17th century, I realized that the Adavas described therein are seen scattered all over South India.
Tam, tadita dalla, dalla takita taka tam tam tadita jolda, tadita dhanada jolda devaram.
I have collected in all about 125 Adavas. Normally, a good teacher teaches about 75 Adavas.
Padubel, how do you define an Adavu?
Adavu is a movement in which The gestures of the hands and the steps of the feet are specified. In concept, the Adava, which is a Deshi term, is not different from the Margi term, Karana.
But Karanas are only poses.
No, my dear. It's a misconception. The definition of Karana is Hasta Pada Samayogaha Nrittasya Karanam Bhavet, which means the combination of the movements of the hands and feet in dance is called Karana. Naturally, the Karana is a unit of dance like the Adavas of today. But they are a different set of movements and not the same as the present Adavas.
So an important constituent of Karana is the Hasta. Akka, can we see the variation of the hands?
You can see the Hastas as part of the entire gamut of Shakas.
Jai Jai Bharat Jai Bharat Jai 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 Jai Bharat